Viewer discretion is advised.
Welcome to Morehead Today. Guests Josh Terry and Josh Wright. And Tyler Keeton. Also, William Borich. Shot on the campus of Morehead State University, out of Studio A in Breckenridge Hall. Here's your host, Merritt.
Hey, and welcome back once again to Morehead Today. So grateful that I could be here again with you this week, because we have a fantastic show that I'm excited to tell you about. That's right. Of course, this is Halloween. That's right. And we have a little theme going. We have a couple of independent filmmakers, actually three independent filmmakers on the show. And they're making some spooky horror films, right? Yeah, so the first one first two guests, actually. Josh Terry and Josh Wright. They are the Josh Brothers. They have Josh Brothers Films. They are the owners and operators there. They're great special effects artists, and they're going to be talking about a film they're currently shooting called Killer Pants. We're going to let them talk about it. It's a throwback to 70s slasher / monster flick, so it's going to be a lot of fun. I actually have a small role in it, and I get to get killed, so that's a lot of fun for me. Up next, we have Tyler Keeton. He is in pre-production currently for a horror film about Black Mountain, about the cult that was said to have been here many years ago. We'll let him tell the story about it. It's a very interesting one, and if you've never heard it, prepare to be shocked, because it is definitely worthy of a horror film. Our musical guest today is William Borich. He was just in Evil Dead with me and played the character of Scott. He's going to tell us about the times he had on stage and rehearsal, and talk a little bit about the fun he had. And also, he's going to play in the trombone for us, a little piece that he's written. And if you'll stick around, relax, when we come back from a commercial break, you'll see the Josh Brothers. Keep it locked down, because this Halloween special is going to be great. Welcome back to Morehead Today. I'd like to welcome our first guests on the show. They are special effects artists, they're filmmakers, they're storytellers. Please welcome Josh Terry and Josh Wright. Thank you so much for being here.
Thank you for having us.
I appreciate you.
Thanks,
guys. Josh Brothers Films.
Yep.
This is Josh Terry. Josh, right on the end over there. So you've got a horror film that you've already started production on, shot a few scenes for, maybe a couple death scenes. And yeah. It's not your typical horror movie, what you would see in the theaters these days. It's it doesn't certainly have a title such as Paranormal Activity or Insidious or something. Killer Pants. How did you come up with something like that?
Actually, this guy over here, we've been making films for short films for years now, but he threw out an idea of maybe making a Killer Pants movie just one day, and I was like, I don't know.
Yeah, I got the idea from I was actually watching How I Met Your Mother, and one of the characters had a pair of pants where every time he wore them, he had unlucky things happen to him. So we just kind of built on that premise, and unlucky turned to killer. So.
Well, I like that. I mean, there's a lot of movies that get made based on earlier, silly things like that. Like Inception It was actually based off of an old DuckTales comic book. Huh. I mean, so you wouldn't guess that, but I mean, something so clever as Inception could come from, you know, the DuckTales. But this is kind of a throwback film. You were telling me earlier, right?
Absolutely.
You want it to be in the style of late 70s, 80s, or
I would say it would probably more along the lines of shot on video of like the late 80s of like stuff that, you know, people. Like these guys just made homemade movies that basically made it to the market in the late 80s and early 90s. So that's kind of what inspired me personally to want to make a movie like this. Just the idea that that they did that back then. So and it would fit, it would have fit in good in like a grindhouse theater type experience or something like that.
Yeah. So on that, it's not supposed to be like taken serious as I don't know, a Friday the 13th or something like that, where a man that could actually come in a hockey mask and kill people or something.
Yeah.
So it's more fun, right? It's not really comical. It's a horror film, but it's more of a fun watch as well.
It has some comedy elements. Like the more we film, the more we find that it's gearing towards a horror comedy, almost, as you would say, to a lot of blood and a lot of gore.
Right.
You know, like over the top.
Right. Well, actually, the death scene you guys filmed in me, I got killed for the first time in a movie, and it was. There was lots of blood. So it was lots of fun. It was very tasty blood, too. So
yeah.
It was like eating a Tootsie Roll, I think. Yep. And now, I mentioned your special effects artist. I mean, how did you... You're really good. Like,
thanks.
You just don't see that every day, you know? As a filmmaker myself, I've ran into many problems that I couldn't fix that I had to use crappy CG graphics.
Right.
Pardon my French there. But, you know, nobody likes CG graphics anymore. I mean, we want to see the old school stuff, kind of like you've... brought back to life in Killer Pants, and I'd like to see more of that in Hollywood, obviously. But
absolutely, yeah.
That doesn't happen. But how did you get started doing something like that? I mean, is it just off the top of your head, or?
Well, kind of like what you were talking about. I just got, tired of seeing every movie come out with a lot of CGI over the top. So I was like, I wanted to see old school special effects, like back in the good old days. So
like Tom Savini's one of our big role models.
Yeah, absolutely.
And I had this actual DVD that had some tips from Tom Savini on it, so I just, kept practicing over and over and just doing different stuff like that. So
yeah, we've actually got a few pictures here, a few images of some special effects that these two guys have done. We'll just take a moment and look at those. Got some good work there, gentlemen, good work. It's looking nice. Yeah, I mean, they look real. I mean, the drill to the ear, I think that was even right? I mean. That looks very real. Was that a real drill?
It was actually. That was my father-in-law. That was filmed in his garage, and I just took the drill, and we took the bit out of it. Obviously, because you don't want to drill into the guy's head.
On the first shot anyway. No.
And then we hit a blood tubing pipe behind his ear and kind of laid his hair over top of it, and we just pumped blood through it. Put the drill to his head. Give the illusion that it's actually drilling into him.
Yeah, well, it was actually a very good illusion, because when I saw that for the first time, I was like, wow, these guys are for real.
Yeah.
Yeah, that was back before I knew you all that well, and I was really impressed with that. And so far with the Killer Pants special effects, I'm really, I'm looking forward to seeing the rest of it, because I'm really impressed with that. You guys do a great job, and I appreciate you guys being on the show today.
Oh, anytime,
it's
man.
It's been
thanks.
Fantastic.
We appreciate it.
Yeah. Appreciate it. All right, and when we come back, we're going to go straight into it. They brought a clip from Killer Pants, and we're going to look at it. And anything you want to say about this clip to set it up?
It's a dream scene. We'll just leave it at that. It probably make more sense once you watch the movie, but it's definitely a dream scene, and it was probably the most awkward thing we've ever filmed. Even though we filmed so much bloody stuff, these few scenes that we put together was pretty awkward to
All
film.
Right. All right. Right now? This is a scene from Killer Pants.
Thank you. I wonder, my little darling, where can you be again tonight while the moon is shining bright? I wonder. My heart is aching. Why for you can our love be mistaken? Darling, don't you say that this must mean our ending? I wonder.
Don't do drugs.
All right, welcome back once again to Morehead Today. And like Josh was saying, if you want to understand that dream sequence that you just watched, you're going to have to watch the film. So when that's done and ready, I want all the support for this film as possible. As for the next guest, I'd like to welcome to the show our next guest. He is also a short independent filmmaker right now, and he's trying to hopefully make his dream come true after this film is finished, and it's about the Clack Mountain cult. So we'll let him tell you more about it. Please welcome Tyler Keeton. Thank you so much for being here. Appreciate it. So going along with the theme of Halloween, you're also making a horror film like the Josh Brothers there. Can you tell us about the history of this, because it's kind of based on a true story?
And the Clack Mountain cult stories, something I grew up hearing. You hear a lot about it, but there's nothing really factual, that can be
right.
proven.
Yeah, and that's the same thing that I've read. I've read that it may have existed. You just don't know.
All they know for sure is that the cult leader, the supposed cult leader, turned himself in the early 70s. That's the only evidence they have. Now, that doesn't mean that there was for sure a cult. It could have been a guy that just wanted to be famous, I guess.
Right.
But for my film itself, I'm going to take that it's true.
Yeah, that gives it a little bit of an edge, I think. I mean, the first time I watched Return of the Living Dead, I think I was maybe 10 years old, but at the beginning of it, it says based on a true story, and of course, it's about these ridiculous zombies that you cannot kill. It scared me to death because it said it's based on a true story, and for the longest time, I slept with my parents because I kept thinking these zombies are going to come get me at night. But so it could be based on a true story. We're not really certain. But what made you want to make this film all of a sudden about, you know, this Clack Mountain cult? I mean,
well, it wasn't just about the cult. I've wanted to make films my entire life. That's what I want to make out of my life. I want to be a filmmaker.
Right. Okay.
But horror specifically has always been my passion. I was approached back in June by Chris Offutt, which is a local author. He moved to LA to become a screenwriter. And he approached me basically asking if I would shoot a movie for him. Of course, I agreed because I wouldn't pass up that chance.
Right. Yeah. Great opportunity.
He's just helping me out. He's not really doing anything for me other than placing it into the film festival itself. He's going to place it in one in LA and probably Mississippi where he lives. So the film is my baby.
Right.
I consider it my baby.
Yeah, so put a lot of hard work into it for sure. You're a great. I guess this, you do the graphic designs for the.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's really good. Like that's,
thank you.
That's really professional looking. It's along those lines. You see, you've got these images that are just really scary. I mean, is all this in the mastermind? I mean, is this like kind of foreshadowing and what we're going to see in this film?
I have ideas. I can't really give too much away right now until the film's actually made. My concept for the film is very clear in my mind. It's different. It's a mixture of a lot of things that I've seen in film before, but I want to take those things to the next level and completely make it my own.
Well, that's exactly what you have to do, and especially to be successful in today's market. It seems like everything's been so overdone. It'd be nice to breath of fresh air to see something not done for a change. So we're looking forward to seeing this film, and we'll wish you the best of luck on getting the project started up. I know you're starting filming here in a couple of weeks.
Probably the end of November.
Right. Okay. Well, wish you the best of luck and hope everything goes well and hope your dreams can come true. Tyler, thank you so much for being here. We appreciate it. When we come back, William Bork is going to be on the couch with us, so stay tuned.
Clayful Young Art Gallery, located in the center of campus, offers a wide variety of art pieces from various contemporary artists in America. Exhibitions rotate approximately once a month and also host art pieces created by Morehead State University students, allowing art majors to experience the learning process of showcasing their art. Clayful Young Art Gallery. Come on over today and be inspired by aspiring MSU artists.
All right, we're back here again at Morehead Today. And I'd like to welcome our next guest. He is a student here at Morehead State. He's a music major and a theater minor. He was just in Evil Dead. He played Scott. And before he strangles me, this time I'm going to get his name right. Please welcome William Borich. William, Will, thank you for being here.
Not a problem. Thanks for having me.
Yes, absolutely. So you just got off your first acting experience ever, right?
First ever.
On stage, too.
Yes.
Wow. So was that nerve-wracking for you for the first time?
It was different, but I've performed before, obviously doing music, playing trombone. I've toured across the country, you know, playing music. So while it was my first acting experience, I've performed before, so it wasn't that nerve-wracking.
Okay. See, for me, that was my first stage experience, besides like a sixth grade Christmas play and, you know, in grade school or something like that. But so it was a little nerve-wracking for me, but you obviously had a lot more lines. And this role you had, you were kind of a jerk.
That's what it was. I was I was a jerk, and it was really weird.
Was that out of your comfort zone, or is that, is that just Will?
Well, I can be kind of sarcastic at times, but all in good humor. So now it was kind of, okay, discarding all of my good sense of humor and just flat out being a plain jerk, for lack of a better term.
Well, you did a very good job.
Well, thank
you. I have to say, out of the whole rehearsal process, you grew more than anyone, I would have to say. And I'll not just say that's just because, well, they're seasoned actors or whatnot. You really put forth an effort every night to make yourself better, and you know that you caused yourself to grow.
Yeah. So, well, I think that's the most important thing you have to do as a performer or in anything, is just always get better at whatever your main gig is.
I totally agree with that.
And you did a fantastic job as well as Ed.
Well, thank you.
You didn't have many lines, but all of the...
they were fun lines.
Yeah, they were fun lines, but all of the body movement that you did was just hilarious and like through and out.
Well, thank you very much. I appreciate that. So you said you went on tour across the country?
Yeah, I did. I did a couple of years of drum corps, and what that is, it's an activity.
Oh, okay.
It's where me and a group of other horn players and drummers, we go touring across the country, sleeping in high schools on gymnasium floors, rehearse all day for about 14 hours in the hot sun.
So this is what you were telling me about, that you never get a, you don't get to stop and eat or...
We just get
exercising all day.
Exercising all day. We get like 45 minutes to eat every 5 hours or so.
Yeah, that's not much.
No.
But you survived it, obviously.
Yeah, I survived. It's a lot more fun than it sounds. You get to go out every
night. Oh, I'm
sure
it is an experience. Yeah, and plus you get to travel, right?
So
I mean, it sounds like a pretty good deal to me.
Yeah.
So, Will, that's all the time we have for you.
All right.
Thank you. I appreciate it.
Thanks for having me.
Morehead State University has several regional campuses across Kentucky, as well as a huge selection of classes offered on the web through their secure online services. MoreheadState.edu also offers several books to read, as well as an online card catalog through its campus library. MSU also provides students with their very own email address. Be sure to check out our Facebook, Twitter, and YouTube links for more information. MoreheadState.edu.
How does my Morehead State help me?
How does my Morehead State help me?
How does my Morehead State help me?
Email, SkyDrive, Blackboard references.
Calendars, maps, news, weather.
It helps me truly connect to my students in and out of class.
It provides me with a tool to succeed in academics and tennis.
Using my Morehead State helps me to stay productive and organized.
When you got some homework and you need a place to go, when you're working on a project and your computer is slow, there's a little place on campus that I think that you should know about. The first story of the library is what I'm talking about. Walk past Java City and then you will see the new commons area is where you should be. They got computers and printers, couches, tables and more. It's the perfect place to go for study time galore.
Hello, I'm Eric Thomas, director of the Star Theater here at Morehead State University, and I'd like to invite you to come out and join us for some of the great programs we offer in the Star Theater. Our programs are both educational, with planetarium programs, and entertaining with laser shows that feature artists such as Elton John all the way out to Metallica. So come join us at the Star Theater, located in the Space Science Center here on the campus of Morehead State University. And if you've got questions, go online to moreheadstate.edu/startheater.
All right, guys, we'd like to thank all of our guests once again for being here this week on Morehead Today. Thank you to the Josh brothers, Josh Terry and Josh Wright. Thank you to William Borich, and thank you to Tyler Keeton. We wish all of those guys much success in their careers, and they're all trying very hard to make the most with their performing arts. So on that note, I got a little, trick, not really a treat right now for this Halloween special. So if the studio control room there will hit it.
Regulators. We regulate any stealing of his property. We're good too.
This is the first rap music video I ever saw, so I fell in love with it. I want to give this a white boy shot. So.
Mount up.
It was a clear black night, a clear white moon. Woman G was on the streets, trying to consume some skirts for the E, so I can get some phone. Rolling in my ride, chilling on the lone. Just hit the east side of the LBC, on a mission trying to find Mr. Warren G. Seen a car full of girls, ain't no need to tweak. All you skirts know what's up with 213. So I hooks a left on 21 and Lewis. Some brothers shooting dice, so I said, let's do this. I jumped out the ride and said, what's up? Some brothers pulled some gas, so I said, I'm stuck. See the girls peeping me, I'ma glide and swerve. These hookers looking so hard, they straight hit the curb. And what you thinking, friends? Some horny tricks. I see my honey and some suckers all in his mix. I'm getting jacked, I'm breaking myself. I can't believe they taken Warren's wealth. They took my rings, they took my Rolex. I glanced at the brother, said, what's next? They homie hemmed up and they all around. Ain't none of them seeing if they're going straight pound for pound. I gotta come up real quick before they start to clown. I best pull up my strap, I lay them busters down. The guns to my head, I think I'm going down. I can't believe it's happening in my own town. If I had wings, I would fly. Let me contemplate. I glanced at the cut and I see my homie Nate. One in the hole, Nate Dogg is about to make some bodies turn cold. Now they dropping and yelling, it's a tad bit late. Nate Dogg and Warren G about to regulate. This is without practicing, guys. That's why I got my lyrics here. That's right. It's my Halloween treat. White and M. Nate got the freaks, and that's a known fact. Before I got jacked, I was on the same track. Back up, cause it's on N-A-T-E and me, the Warren to the G. Just like I thought, they were in the same spot, in need of some desperate help. The Nate Dogg and the G Chime were in need of something else. One of them dames was sexiest, said, ooh, I like your size. She said, my car's broke down, it just seemed real nice, would you let me ride? I got a car full of girls and it's going real swell. Stop is the east side. I'm done.